Electric vehicles make gasoline look so 2007, and people are switching in droves. The world's gonna buy 1 million electric cars in 2018, according to JP Morgan. That's 40% more than last year, and it might just be the beginning. Mercedes plans to offer an electric option on every model within 5 years, similar story at Rover. And Nissan? Well, they say half of all their sales globally will be electric by 2025. Here's the thing though, for all the excitement about electric vehicles, we still haven't figured out how to source all the lithium all those electric batteries are gonna need. It's probably more than the current supply, and that's what gets my attention as an investor. I actually think lithium is the play here. So let me tell you about lithium. It's, well, the world's lightest metal. It floats in water. And half the world's deposits come from underground reservoirs in a remote area between Chile, Argentina, and Bolivia. It's called the Lithium Triangle. Miners pump lithium-infused salt water to the surface. They fill up pools the size of football fields and then let it evaporate over 2 years. Eventually, they're left with a highly concentrated lithium mud that they process. Oh, and did I mention? Just 4 companies control 80% of the world's lithium supply. So sensing a bottleneck, Chile signed a deal in February to open additional mining rights, but actual production, obviously, is gonna take several years, and that doesn't include the evaporation time. So while demand for electric vehicles ramps up over the next few years, getting enough lithium in the meantime, that presents a real challenge. It's a classic case of supply and demand. Let me just run you through the numbers. Okay, last year, electric vehicles and buses ate up 160 kilotons of lithium. If electric car sales speed up this year and make up, say, 2% of all cars sold, then total EV demand for lithium will be about 250 kilotons. Add in all the other stuff lithium is used for, you're gonna need 400 kilotons. Too bad there's only 260 kilotons of supply in the whole world. There's just not enough to go around, and that is very bullish for lithium. Okay, so here's my trade. Time for a little insight and action. US-based Albemarle, ticker ALB on the New York Stock Exchange, it's the world's largest lithium miner. It operates mostly in Chile, but thanks to that production deal I just told you about, well, the stock has been on sale, right? People think there's gonna be more supply, but it's gonna take a long time. I love quality to discount. So I'm buying Albemarle under 100 bucks. My target is 175. I've got a $75 stop loss. In case I'm wrong, which I don't think I am, I admit it's not cheap at 22 times earnings, but I like the risk reward. And with 15% earnings growth forecast, I see a lot of upside. Actually, I think those estimates are too low. With the world buying electric vehicles, I want to buy the world's best lithium supplier, and that is Albemarle. Now, let's say that you actually prefer the diversification of exchange-traded funds. No problem. You can buy the Global X Lithium and Battery ETF. That ticker is LIT. Bottom line, drive smart, invest smart. I'm Adam Johnson, and this is Karma.